Madam MC. My job today is a very easy one. It's just to welcome you here tonight. But first and foremost, allow me to acknowledge that we are meeting in the land of the Kwana people, who are the traditional owners of this land, and I would like to respect their ancestral connection to this land. Then, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to acknowledge specific officials that are in our presence today. Let me acknowledge the President of South Australian Legislative Council, Mr. Russell Wortley. Allow me also to acknowledge the MP for the Torrens electorate, Mrs. Diana Wortley. Allow me also to acknowledge the Mayor of Port Adelaide and Enfield City, Gary Johansson, and his wife, Vicky. Allow me also to acknowledge the President of the African Communities Organization of South Australia, Dr. David Malinda, and his wife, Caroline. Allow me also to acknowledge the President of Kenyan Community Association of South Australia, Mr. Geoffrey Baraka, and his wife, Winnie Baraka. Let me also acknowledge the Secretary of the African Communities Organization of South Australia, ACOSA. He is also the Chairperson of Zim Pride. He is also the Secretary of the South Australian Zimbabwe Community Association, Mr. David Shepherd Mutuza, and his wife, Emily. And last but not least, allow me to acknowledge the Chairperson of South Australian Zimbabwe Association, Mr. Thaya Mzimanga. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me tonight to take this opportunity on behalf of Divine Orchestra Music Ministry to welcome you to 2016 World Night Africa in Australia. We really take pleasure to have you here. It is really nice to see our diversity. It is really nice to see how we have gathered, we have left everything, and we have met here today, and we really appreciate. The World Night is an annual event. It was launched last year in 2015 by the Minister of Multicultural Affairs. And last year, with the money that we raised, we were able to fund fight against Ebola, as we donated all the proceeds to an organization called All as One Orphanage in Freetown, Sierra Leone, Africa. And most kids in that orphanage have been deeply affected by Ebola, and we thought that Ebola, it is indeed an international disaster that needs international intervention. This year, we hope that with the funds that we are going to raise, we will build the internal capacity of our organization so that we can be able to take our mission to the next level. And our 2016 objectives are to continue creating cultural awareness and foster cultural competence among and between Australians. I want you to know that we are an Australian registered incorporated organization. We work within culturally and linguistically diverse people, but we have a very strong emphasis on the young people. We also have branches in overseas, particularly in Africa at the moment. We have branches in Zimbabwe, Kenya, Lesotho, South Africa, Botswana, and we hope that we will expand to other countries very soon. Like I've said, we bring together people from different cultures and different backgrounds, and we learn from each other, we share everything, and we make life or the world indeed a better place. And we have our executive committee. And right now, I would like to call upon those members of the executive committee to come so that you can see them, so that you can identify with them, and so that if you need anything, you can be able to ask. And as they are coming up to the stage, I would like also to appreciate our sponsors. I would like to appreciate the artists, the people who have come in here to entertain us, and everything that we have done. Without you, this event would not be a success. So, as members of the executive committee, please come to the stage so that I can introduce you properly. And I also appreciate if our MC can also come to the stage so that we can have a nice photo with you. And as they are coming, ladies and gentlemen, another thing is there will be food that drinks in that corner. But like we said, you should remember that this is wild night in Africa, so we are like in the jungle. So when the food comes, the strongest lion can take the largest share. And if you are not that lion, but the food will be put in the table, so we will just be eating like we are in the jungle in Africa. So let's have that in mind. And I would like to introduce them one more. Close right, we have Mr. Jason, who is the chairperson and the visionary of this ministry, and I want you to acknowledge him. And on my far next to him, I have Mr. Mudamu Fambere. He is the Vice Chairperson, he is also the PRO of Divine Orchestra Ministry. So let us also acknowledge him. And this lady that has just joined us is Leanne. He's the one that is going to hold every finance that we are collecting here. He's the one that has the purse. So please, when you look at her, he is the purse holder, Mrs. Treasurer. And then we have Caroline, and he is the coordinator. She is the one that deals with the artists. She's the one that knows what. She is even an artist herself, so she is the one that really brings the music to the team. Others are not here, but I think. This is good enough for us tonight. So I think the photo is already been taken. And ladies and gentlemen, as they are taking the photo, allow me to officially declare World Night Africa in Australia 2016 officially opened.